H3H327. Definite integral. What is definite integral? This is our new topic. Let an integral of the type integration from a to b f of x dx. F, this is a derivative of some function f of x, and we put the limit upper and lower limit f of b minus f of a. This difference is called the definite integral. For example, integration from 2 to 4 x dx, which is equal to x square by 2, limit 4 to 2, putting 4 square minus 2 square divided by 2, which is equal to 6. Now, Riemann integration. Riemann defined a famous theory of Riemann integrations. Consider an enclosed interval AB, and we take partition of this interval AB by dividing S delta x is equal to B minus A divided by N, and consider the partition S A plus delta x, A plus delta x, and A plus 2 delta x, and so on. Consider this curve in the closed interval A and B, and we divide this area under the curve in small integral pieces. Now, taking left in front of each subinterval, we get delta x. Now, you know that the area of a rectangle, this is the length and this is the width. Multiplying length and width, we get area of first integral. Multiplying length and width by small m2, we get the second integral. Small m2 means f of x2 and so on, f of xn. Summation r is equal to 1 up to n delta x f of x r. If this partition is uniform and the breadth width is equal to delta x in each rectangle. Similarly, taking the right in point, the right in point of each subinterval, and taking the upper partition u f of v delta x capital M1, this is the this right length, this is the right length of each subintegral rectangle, and summation from r is equal to 1 up to n. Now, Riemann says if n tends to infinity, then delta x tends to 0, because you know that if n tends to infinity, divided anything by infinity, we get 0. Now, putting these things in relation 1 and 2, we get this is known as a lower integral, and this is known as upper integral. Riemann says if upper and lower integral, if this lower integral is equal to the upper integral, and this is equal to integral from a to b f of x, this we say that function f of x will be Riemann integrable if upper integral is equal to the lower integral. Now, we calculate an integral of a to b x square dx. Let delta x is equal to b minus a. Let b delta x is equal to b minus a divided by n. Taking partition of a b interval is a plus delta x, a plus delta x, a plus 2 delta x, and so on, a plus n minus 1 delta x, a plus n delta x. Taking left in point of each subinterval, we get delta x f of a delta x f of a plus delta x and so on, plus delta x f of a plus n minus 1 delta x. Now now we know that f of x is equal to x square. Putting in x square, f of a, this is f of a, this is f of a plus delta x, and so on, a square, a plus delta x whole square, and so on, a plus n minus 1 delta x whole square. Now, opening, expanding these squares, a square, 2 times first second, second square, and so on, plus first square, twice a first second, and second square. Now, there are n a square, so adding these n a square, 2 a delta x, and similarly in second term, 4 a delta x, and so on, 2 a n minus 1 delta x, and similarly delta x square, 4 delta x square, and so on, n minus 1 delta x whole square. Taking common here, in a square, here taking 2 a delta x common, here 1, here 2, and so on, and last n minus 1. Similarly, taking delta x whole square common, we get 1 square, here 2 square, and last n minus 1 whole square. Now, summing these series, we get, now you know from FAC that 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus n minus 1, this series is equal to this one, and this series is equal to this one. Putting these in the last series, we get simplified form of the series S. Crossing 2 with 2, we get left sum of left in partition F M P delta x in a square, b my delta x is equal to b minus a divided by n, and this is a taking in common n square and 1 minus 1 over n delta x means b minus a divided by n whole square n, taking in common this become n cube 1 minus 1 over n 2 minus 1 over n whole divided by 6. Now putting delta x is equal to b minus a over n and multiplying with this brackets, we get n multiplied inside, n will cancel with n, here n will cancel with n in here. Now taking n tends to infinity, delta x is equal to 0, and putting these limit in this thing, we get b minus a square plus ab minus a square. Now you know that when we applied limit n tends to infinity, delta x tends to 0, in Riemann theory, this has become integration from a to b of f(x) dx, which is equal to b minus a square ab minus a square will be a square cancel, and simplifying this thing, we get b minus ab a square plus b square minus 2ab, taking LCM 3ab plus a square plus b square minus 2ab a square b square plus ab divided by 3, multiplying, we get the required result. Now, evaluation of limit of sum. This is a limit. 1 over n f of 1 over n f of 2 over n plus f of n over n. This limit is equal to 0 to 1 f of x dx. So generally, we take partition of this interval 0, 1 close interval s delta x is equal to b minus a divided by n. Here b is equal to 1 and 0 is a. So this is 1 over n. Taking partition 0, 1 over n, 1 over n, 2 over n and so on in minus 1 divided by n over n. Taking right in point of each subinterval, right in point of each subinterval, u f of phi delta x f of 1 over n delta x f of 2 over n delta x f of n over n. Now delta x is equal to 1 over n, putting 1 over n and placing f of 1 over n, f of 2 over n, f of n over n, limit n tends to infinity, delta x tends to 0. This is a limit from 0 to 1 f of x dx, and this is the required result. Now by this limit of sum, we solve this example. This is find the limit of sum. 1 over n plus 1, 1 over n plus 2, and 1 plus n over n tends to infinity. This is equal to limit n tends to infinity. 1 over n, 1 over 1 plus 1 over n, 1 over 1 plus 2 over n, 1 plus 1 over 1 n over n. Now you know that this is equal to f, we put 1 over n is equal to x. This thing is equal to 1 plus x. So generally, this series by the previous definition is equal to 0 to 1, 1 over 1 plus x. We know that the derivative of this is 1. So this is equal to natural log of 1 plus denominator. Putting the limit 1 plus 1 minus the natural log of 2 minus 0, natural log of 2 is the required answer.